The HKUST Computer Engineering Program emphasizes the integration of computer science and electronic engineering for our students to learn the best of both worlds. Hello, I'm Professor Wei Wang, Associate Director of the HKUST Computer Engineering Program. In this video, I will introduce the HKUST Computer Engineering Program, its curriculum, and its research and facilities to you. The HKUST Computer Engineering Program is an interdisciplinary program jointly run by the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, CSE, and the Department of Electronic and Computer Engineering, ECE. The CPAC program offers a rich and challenging curriculum for motivated students who are interested in pursuing an engineering career. With a unique research emphasis and well-equipped laboratories, our forward-looking education teaches you advanced and practical computer technologies and how to make sound decisions in various engineering business environments. What and why is computer engineering? Everybody knows that computer is everywhere. You can see it in smartphones, robots, your laptop, drones, automation, and satellite communications. Actually, computer and computing can be seen everywhere. You can see that technologies progress at the most rapid rate and it changes the way we live every day now and in the future. So computing is advancing in our fields in businesses, finance, and medicine sectors, and it empowers the world's economy, for example, Amazon and Twitter. The revolution is far from over. For example, in year 2000, we can know that the Macintosh computer is very expensive and heavy. But in 10 years, we can see that smartphones are much more powerful and less expensive than the Macintosh computer. So this is due to the fact that the speed and capacity of computers doubles every 18 to 24 months. This is what we call the Moore's Law. The revolutionary breakthroughs are in many different ways. For example, artificial intelligence, data analytics, and sensor signals, but this is just the beginning. There is a lot of room to develop in many countries. This is a field of huge jobs and intellectual opportunity. The computer revolution is only the second half of the chessboard. We are experiencing an exponential growth in the capability of computers. We call this a second machine age. Our lives will be enhanced by intelligent machines in a way that is beyond our imagination. For example, in object connections, we have IoT, which provides universal connectivity. We have processors and sensors almost everywhere when 5G is coming. So we have advanced in robotic, for example, unmanned cars. Also, everybody knows this is also related to advances in AI and big data. So what is the CPAC program in our school? CPAC is about the design and use of computers and computing devices to benefit the lives of human beings. CPAC focuses on all aspects of computer technology and applications. It maintains a good balance and bridges the gap between the software side and the hardware side. CPAC program at HKUST is jointly run by CSE and ECE departments. We offer the best of both worlds for undergraduates in the School of Engineering. Our management committee manages the CPAC program, and the members come from the faculties of both CSE and ECE. We also have the facilities, for example, the laboratories from both departments. How about CPAC careers and prospects? Most of our graduates start with a technical position in many fields, such as system analysis, computer programming, electronic network, and field sales support engineering. They will progress into senior positions in technical management, system analysis and consultancy, marketing and sales, and general management. Some graduates become academics, researchers, and entrepreneurs. Our CPAC graduates always have great job offers from engineering, government, education, or commercial sectors, and employers keep coming back to us. Our experience tells us that the career prospects in CPAC is in a wide variety of industries, For example, finance and banking, electronics, software, telecom, transportation and utilities, government, social services, education, and so on and so forth. Here, I am showing the CPAC graduates' employment statistics in the last year, according to the employment by sector. You can see in this simple pie chart, over half of our graduates will go to commerce and business field, and also quite a significant number of them will go into engineering and industries. Others will go into education, government, and community and social services. According to employment status, you can see in this graph that in last year, most of our CPAC graduates are fully employed. Of course, some of them will go to further their study in MPhil program or PhD program. Also, the monthly gross incomes are comparable to other disciplines in our university. CPAC is a specialized engineering discipline in our School of Engineering. CPAC students will take a couple of university common core courses related to humanities, social analysis, wellness, communication skills in their junior years. They will also study engineering fundamentals such as mathematics, physics, and basic programming. In their senior years, they will take required courses from two main areas of software and hardware. Fundamental courses from both areas, such as algorithms and electronics, are required. Then system fundamentals, such as computer organization and embedded systems, are also included in their curriculum. CPAC students in their senior years will choose electives from a wide range of areas of specialization. So now I'm going to give more details on those areas of specialization. In the area of artificial intelligence and theory, we have courses on machine learning, intelligent systems, and theory of computation. In the area of embedded system and robotics, we have courses in ARM core hardware, software-based systems, and automatic control systems. In the area of graphics and multimedia, we have courses on video and audio compression, and computer games and graphics. In the area of semiconductor and VLSI, we have courses on sensors, power electronics, IC design, and architecture. In the area of signal processing, we have courses on signal analysis, medical imaging, and speech and image compression. In the area of software and database, we have courses on operating systems, theory of computation, and database management. In the area of systems and networking, we have courses on design of internet and computer networks. In the area of communications, we also have courses on digital, wired, and wireless communication. We understand that young and motivated students need the highest degree of curriculum flexibility as they explore their individual academic interests. We offer a wide range of curricula in regard to minors, honors programs, study options, and concentrations. For example, CPAC students can choose minor programs of business, mathematics, physics, humanities, and social science, and so on. We also have a wide range of research options. Top students who would like to experience R&D work or who plan to pursue a career in high-tech research and development or management work. Through frequent faculty-student interaction, we inspire, challenge, and guide our students to be the leaders of their fields. Therefore, you can fully develop your potential in a multidisciplinary setting. Our students perform excellently and receive numerous awards in different competitions, conferences, and exhibitions. Realizing that world-class engineers need to develop a global perspective, we offer international exposure with ample opportunities to interact with foreign students inside and outside classrooms, and to exchange overseas in top institutions around the world. I hope you have some ideas on what the CPAC program is. You may also visit our website for further information of the program, or please contact us if you have any questions. Experience our rewarding environment and engineer your bright future. joining us in HKUST CPAC, and we hope to see you soon. Thank you.